Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trofinet and welcome back to Bioshock 2 in our Let's Replay series where we try to delve a bit deeper into the story of this game and the backstory of it as well, the idea the developers had with especially this level, since they had different plans for it at the start. It's also one of the first levels they started on. That's really, really nice. We're here at the center carousel. We're gonna use our last gather on this corpse. And I set up a bit of traps alongside the area here. So a couple of cyclone traps, a wall with an explosive proximity mine on a gas bottle, so why not? And then the staircase of doom. I like to call this bad boy the staircase of doom. So let's drop our little sister on top of this corpse and get this show on the road. I think I'm gonna hide. No, I'm not gonna hide in that thing. That's a bit stupid. I'm gonna hide in this corner. Is it sleeping? So there's someone coming out of there. I think she just died because of the trap. Let's go with incinerate. Yeah, I like incinerate. There we go. There goes another one in my traps.
Oh my gosh, bees!
Bees? Yes, bees. Hi. So I put down a bee swarm trap as well, because those are really, really nice. As you can see, because they just stopped those splicers in their traps. Yeah, you're all done apparently. Thank you very much. That tonic is really doing work, because I don't think anything just triggered. I put down amazing traps and nobody triggered them. Oh god, give me a second. I'm going to just gather everything up again. So, gathered everything back up and that should be all. I'm wondering if there is actually a little sister vent near the train tracks. Because if there is, I want to drop her off right there. Because we're pretty much done with Dionysus Park right now. I'm wondering what actually happens if you bring a little sister to... I knew there was only... Okay, I was going to say there was only one splicer on the ground here, but apparently there were two. That scared the bejesus out of me. I'm not... What the... That's a weird noise. Okay, then. So, did pull my attention towards the two dead splicers. You're dead, right? Yeah, you are. I am gonna be scared shitless of everything right now. Let's see, can I buy a few more E-pipos? Maybe I should. Why is it so loud? Well, let's just heal. There's another E-pipo over here. Nothing in the save anymore. I thought I left some things in there. I'm wondering. Yeah, I'm really curious how Stanley reacts if you put a little sister in his face. Let's check it out, why don't we, eh? Because there's not a vent around here, so I'm gonna have to return otherwise, but this should be fun. Stanley, I've brought you something.
There's still another girl out there.
Yeah, she's on my shoulder. On my shoulder, see her? See her? You want her? You're not getting her. Is there one over here? There doesn't seem to be one over here, so I'm gonna pull through here and that should lead us back. There's another E-pipe over there. Lead us back up. I hear another big daddy, not that we need to fight one. Where's the vent? Where's the vent? Do you know where the vent is? You should know it. Oh, there we go. There's one right over here. Goodbye, girl. Goodbye. Have a nice life and all that. Not turning up as a big sister. So yeah, there we go. That's the last one. Hello.
With me gone, Father, Stanley just let Mother's followers turn into animals. When word came that she was returning, he knew they would blame him. So he found a way to silence them all. And now he's trying to cover it up.
So there we go, confirming what we already knew.
That's it. Now all that old dirt stays underground, and Lamb will be none the wiser. Hey, come on back. I've unlocked the train for you. But remember, If Lamb catches you, mum's the word.
Yeah, mum's the word, Stanley. Because Stanley is a decrepit piece of shit. He's a terrible human being.
Delta, I have known for years of Stanley's betrayal here, and had forgiven him. But in compromising Eleanor now, he seals his fate. You see, it was Stanley who turned you into Ryan. He is responsible for what you have become. The security booth is open now. You may have your revenge.
Sweet Jesus. Lamb, no! And she just let me hang myself out the... Oh, God! No. Come on, pal. The train's ready. Just let me live!
So now we get another of these decisions. And as you might remember, we had to do the same with Grace Holloway. But I believe that this is... Oh, shit. Kind of forgot about that. That's... Oh shit, I'm gonna have to move because I don't want to do that fight right in front of Stanley. Yeah, because there's Big Sister is coming. Big Sister is coming. Let's go back to the center area over here. Yeah, a bit of space. Let's put down a few mini turrets. Let's use the two I still have and then armor piercing rounds.
Mother's not lying this time, Father. He really did it.
I'm kind of busy, Eleanor. Hi! Okay, there we go. New research level reached. Everything is going together. Your little sister restores your health after gathering Adam. That's really good. Really nice of her. I don't know if she's vulnerable to that, but... Stop firing at my turrets! Okay, so that's pretty much everything of that. Oh, I hope. So she's trying to gather her strengths by using one of the splicers. She's tough, holy shit. Yeah. Hi. Hi. No. Jesus Christ, this thing fires slowly. Let's finish her off with some shotgun blasts. There we go. Holy. Okay, the Big Daddy is not mad at us apparently. So gather the spears, get the Adam, and now we can continue our decision making with Stanley. Whew, that was... Kind of forgot about her for a second. Let's get this Eve hypo. Thank you very much. Let's buy some more. Is there? Oh no, I can smack that thing probably. Smack that thing in the face. Thank you very much. Give me the first aid kit. And now we have a decision. So we have three reasons to kill Stanley over here. Because he was A, responsible for the death of everybody here. Hello, Stanley. Hello. Secondly, he's responsible for turning Eleanor into a little sister. And thirdly, he's also responsible for us turning into a Big Daddy because he turned us into Ryan. I'm doing a good playthrough, so I'm not going to kill him. But yeah, he's a really bad man.
So, Lamb broke out. And she's coming back. Wow. Okay. Didn't see that coming, but... Okay. Oh, that is gonna be... Oh, what am I gonna do? And I've heard some of these... A lot of these people down here talking. Some of them, I know, saw the thing with Eleanor and... Who knows what? You can't just stop... You know, a whole cult from... From talking, can you? Well, maybe you can. Yeah. Maybe you can.
Maybe you can. So because at least one of them would rat him out, he killed everybody in Dionysus Park.
Don't. Please.
So it's a really, really large difference between this and Grace Holloway, because Grace Holloway was mad at us because of a misunderstanding, but this guy is a piece of shit. I'm not gonna kill him, but yeah, he deserves it a lot more than Grace Holloway did, so... kinda big difference between those. So let's get on the train and get out of here onto the next area. Here we go. And now, things are gonna get really, really interesting, cause we are at Fontaine Futuristics.
This is it, Chief. End of the line. If I'm right, Eleanor's mama's using Adam to force all Rapture's minds and memories into the poor girl. Lamb reckons it'll make that child a saint. Now, Eleanor's in a deep, dark place beneath Fontaine headquarters, and to keep you alive, we need to sneak in and find her.
There we go. So we're right where Eleanor is supposedly kept prisoner. And yeah, we're gonna try and take her back. Because Fontaine Futuristics is really, really cool level. I really like it, especially because of the characters in the level. And I know I say this a lot, but it is actually one of my favorite levels in Bioshock 2. Fontaine Futuristics. And we have an audio diary introducing us to this level. And there we go, Ascension is near, because if you kind of forgot, this is also the headquarters of Sophia Lamb, so we're going to see a lot of the butterflies and the stuff over here. Let's listen to Alone at Last first.
This facility belongs to the city now, to Ryan Industries, at least until the rioting subsides. While it is unfortunate that such measures had to be taken, I must admit... it is gratifying to see this building condemned. Fontaine is gone. Lamb is gone. Or close enough. I am alone at last. Alone with my city.
So Andrew Ryan kicking back after he vanquished all of his competitors. Now I'm gonna have to take this really, really carefully. I think I'm gonna go with Insect Swarm. And look at this thing, a shrine for Lamb, for the Lamb, if you want to see it like that. Hello, let's kick you in the face, and then let's just drill you, because yeah, the bees are going to take care of everything. There we go, taken care of really easily. Lamb is watching, yes, she is, probably. Spear ammo, kind of okay with that. As you, right now we get most of our spears back actually, so we don't really lose a lot of spear ammo. So, Seized, Ryan Industries, by Ryan Industries. Because if you remember, Fontaine Futuristics was seized by Ryan after Fontaine was supposedly killed, because he actually never died. And there we have, Please Hurry Daddy, because we're getting really, really close. Damage Research, that is of course really interesting. Are you a master of research? Get the most of your unlocked damage bonuses with Damage Research. I think I'm gonna go with that over... What am I gonna take instead? Maybe take that instead of Drill Lurker. Because Damage Research is, of course, a general damage boost on anything that we build a research bonus on. So yeah, that's gonna come in handy. Anything else around here? Doesn't seem like there is. And there we go.
October 9th, 1967. Hello. My name is Gilbert Alexander. And by the time you hear this, I will be clinically insane. I am recording these diaries in advance as a last-ditch effort to assist anyone I might threaten in dealing with me. My next message awaits you beyond the security checkpoint. The bioscan will ensure that you're sane enough to need it.
So there we go. We've heard a lot about this scientist, Jill Alexander.
Gil Alexander. As I recall, he was involved in Big Daddy development from the beginning. Likely had something to do with you and Eleanor, son.
Because, yeah, indeed, he did. Airlock, yeah, I wanna turn that over, but... No? Oh, there we go, cycle. Because we need to go through the water again, because the bridge leading towards Fontaine Futuristic is, out of business. Out of order. So as you can see, there should be a bridge here, but yeah, kind of broke down. Because there's a pipe still running here, but that's about it. I think there's a few atom slugs around here, so I'm going to have to take a look around. Hello? Hello, hello? Not really seeing any of those, but this is still really, really cool. Oh, there's one. There's one. There's one. Can't really reach it right now. Storage crate. Thank you very much. And a corpse. And an atom. 10 atom. Thank you very much. Gonna come in handy, of course. Every little bit helps. Who doesn't like the small things is not worth the bigger ones. Isn't he? I thought there were more. Is there only one? I'm not really sure. Let's check things a bit more thorough. But I don't think, yeah, that must be the only one here then. Not that it makes that much of a difference, of course, but I do like to be a bit of a completionist, even though I probably missed a few things already. So yeah, this is another really nice level, isn't it? And Fontaine Futuristics just looks really, really ominous over there. But let's get inside and see if we can find Gil Alexander, because yeah, his recording was from a very, very long time ago, and he mentioned that he probably went insane by now. We don't really know why, but he apparently realized that he was going to get insane. You're fired. Yeah, we're fired apparently. That was burned into the wall by that bolt over there. But first, heavy rivets. Yes, thank you very much. We're actually out of heavy rivets. Could have used that on the big sister, I realize that now. But yeah, we're gonna have to remember that for later. Hello, sir. You look better. You're fired. So yeah, that's probably the guy that got fired. He kind of died. Okay. So those are splicers. Okay. So he just shocked that splicer. That was interesting. Okay, so Alex the Great. Hello. I shocked you. Oh, seriously? God damn it. Hello? Jesus Christ. Okay, she seems to be dead. Where the hell is that coming from? There we go. I'm running out of bullets. Hi. Jesus Christ.
Alex the Great. Oh, hell, that has to be Gil Alexander. Same man who left that message we're following. He sounds mad as a March hare now.
Because, yeah, well, he kind of is. Because he just sent a lot of splices our way, didn't he? Let's hack this lovely thing. Ooh, that's speeding up rather nicely, isn't it? That was impressive. So, yeah. Every level we come across, the difficulty of the hacks increases, though. Yeah, the arrow is going pretty fast. Not that I have that much issue with that, but yeah, it's gonna probably bite us in the ass sooner rather than later. So let's buy a few of the rounds, so we still have a bit of ammo left. And let's take a look around this place, because yeah, Fontaine Futuristics is now under the caretakership of Gil Alexander, or Alex the Great, as he calls himself right now. And yeah, the man is not right in the brain, not right in the head. So yeah, let's get up and try to get through this biometric scanner.
Initiating bioscan.
Hi.
Identifying clearance level.
Hi.
Identified. Clinical trial subject. Classification. Protector. Designation. Delta. Status. Deceased. Error. Updating status. Please stand by.
So status deceased. Updating status. Because of course they don't want to let any dead guy inside.
Vouchers for you? Delta, you're one of our old protectors, yes? You're a fine product, Delta. Yes, fine product. Built to last. Say, don't look now. But I believe one of your old colleagues wants to welcome you back to the office.
One of our old colleagues. I'm going to use my research camera for this. Because our old colleagues is actually one of the Alpha series. So as you can see, this guy looks like us. There we go. Alpha series is vulnerable to armor-piercing rounds. And he actually lobs grenades. Nope. Toreador. Oh, I think he's dead. Alex the Great, your personnel is kind of dead. Look at this. Thank you. Thank you very much. I'm quickly gonna check the upper levels here. Just in case we missed anything, anti-personnel rounds, always handy. So let's swap back the dose for a minute. Is there something in between here? No. Bad texturing, that's what's in between there. Seems like there's more heavy rivets over there, so maybe I'm gonna just quickly scoot over to those. Because I don't think I have any more space for heavy rivets. Sadly, but... no. Okay, so we're out of space for heavy rivets. So, let's enter Fontaine Futuristics. We're allowed in by the biometric scanner. Hello.
Hello again. I have been exposed to a massive dose of substance atom. By the time you hear this, I will have armed this facility's defenses en masse. You, my friend, must therefore penetrate them and kill me. Please believe that if I could have done it myself... and on that cheery note, you may use the diary lying near this screen to bypass the vocal print locks ahead and enter the security office. The password is Agnes Day.
Agnes Day. I'm not really sure what Agnes means, but Day is of gold. So Agnes, I'm not really sure. I might check that out before we, when we start the next episode. So let's pick that up, and that just says
Agnes Day.
The password. There we go. So we now can use that to bypass the next lock on our way towards, Eleanor, the secret area underneath Fontaine Futuristics. That was really, really bad for a save. There was practically nothing in there. Let's see. I think, yeah, that's the biometric, that's the voice activated switch. So let's play the password.
Password to enter.
Agnes Day.
There we go.
Access granted. Welcome, Gil Alexander.
Yeah, thank you.
I heard that. My likeness is company property, Delta, just like you are. Don't make me strip you for parts, Milado!
So Alex the Great doesn't like that very much because, he doesn't want us to reach him, of course. But with that done, before we head into Fontaine Futuristics proper, I'm gonna take a little break. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye!